next guests are some of the busiest actors in Hollywood, whether it's starring on hit TV shows or the biggest movies, they do it all. Next, they're joining forces to take down one of Hollywood's biggest villains of all time in the new movie, Godzilla, King of the Monsters. Please welcome Aisha Hinds and O'Shea Jackson Jr. Talk about the film you're both in. We'll talk about that in a little bit. Okay. But first, O'Shea, you've been busy with other monsters. Oh, oh my. Okay.
Yes.
The stars of Game of Thrones. I'm a huge fan.
Yeah.
You binged the entire series just to get ready for the final season. So how did that go for you?
It was pretty abusive. It's a pretty long show, but you can't put it down. You know,
no.
Once you get going, you get going.
It's addictive.
And I just want you to know, Bran Stark is the worst character on the show.
Oh,
on the show. I mean, like, you could tell the future, you could tell the past, but you can't get no hints. Like, people are dying out here.
That is true.
It.
He always keeps quiet.
Good point.
Aisha, you're actually on hiatus from your show, 911. So what do you do on your downtime?
I go down.
Lay it down.
You know, because we spend so much time we have an aggressive production schedule.
Yeah.
It took us about 9 months out of the year to complete our second season. So literally, like, I spent the week sleeping on a boat last week. I was in Miami.
Nice. Good life.
Went back to one of my favorite cities, Miami. You know, I read books. Mm-hmm. I serve with the Innocence Project as one of their ambassadors.
Nice. So tell us more about that, the Innocence Project.
The Innocence Project is a nonprofit organization that basically helps people who are in prison innocently.
Right.
So they reach out to the people.
So many of them.
And there are so many people in prison who've been imprisoned and are serving double-digit sentences for crimes that they did not commit.
Right.
You know, and so it was something that appealed to me to just lend my platform and my voice to give a voice
so
to
great.
People who just need that amplification, you know, who need to be heard. Because once they're behind the wall, I think there's a perception about people behind the wall that they're just guilty, all of them, you know.
Right.
And there are so many... so many systems in place to put people there, you know, without proper justification.
That is awesome. We applaud you for what you're doing.
Really, yeah.